The United Nations Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC, released a report warning that the Earth is on track to surpass the critical global warming threshold of 1.5 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels within the next decade. This target was established in the 2015 Paris Climate Agreement. The report states that global average temperatures are expected to exceed this threshold sometime in the early 2030s. China and the United States are the top two emitters of greenhouse gases, with China's emissions increasing approximately threefold since the year 2000. The report also notes that the planet has already warmed by an average of 1.1 degrees Celsius since the industrial age. The IPCC urges industrialized nations to reduce emissions by 60% by 2035 compared to 2019 levels. It is believed that achieving net zero emissions by the middle of the century may stabilize temperatures at least a decade later. The IPCC's next assessment report will be published in 2027. The five things we can learn from the UN climate report are: 1. Overshoot is the key word, and it is likely that the world will breach 1.5 degrees in the 2030s. The focus should be on coming back down as quickly as possible after overshooting this mark. 2. There's no future for coal, oil, and gas on a livable planet. The report highlights how renewable forms of energy such as wind and solar are now cheaper, and that sticking with fossil fuels may be more expensive in many places than switching to low-carbon systems. 3. The actions that people can take make a massive difference to the overall picture, and we could cut 40 to 70% of projected 2050 emissions with end-use measures. This includes shifting to plant-based diets, avoiding flights, building more walkable and bikeable cities. 4. Our actions now will resonate for thousands of years, and the decisions we make over the next 7 years will echo down the centuries. Governments need to up their commitments before 2030 to reach net zero by 2050 in order to keep warming in or around 1.5 degrees by 2100. 5. It's now about the politics, not just the science. The future of fossil fuels is becoming more and more a political question, and this new IPCC report will be central to it when countries meet again at 28 Colombian pesos in Dubai later this year. The distribution of global cumulative CO2 emissions has undergone significant changes over time. Prior to 1950, Europe accounted for over half of the world's historical CO2 emissions, with the UK being the primary contributor until 1882. The United States saw a rapid increase in its contribution over the next century due to industrialization. The past 50 years have witnessed a growth in South America, Asia, and Africa, resulting in these regions increasing their share of total contribution. It is estimated that the United States has contributed the most global CO2 emissions since 1750, accounting for 25% of historical emissions. China is the second largest national contributor, but its cumulative emissions are only half of the United States. The European Union is also a significant contributor, accounting for 22% of historical emissions. Many of the large annual emitters today, such as India and Brazil, have not been major contributors in a historical context and are not necessarily the largest emitters today. For instance, the UK's contribution to global emissions in 2017 was only 1%. Africa's regional contribution has been very small due to its low per capita emissions, both historically and currently. Global average temperatures are exceeding because of global warming, which is actually a rapid increase in Earth's average surface temperature, primarily due to the release of greenhouse gases by human activities, such as burning fossil fuels and deforestation. This enhanced greenhouse effect leads to warming temperatures and significant impacts, such as changes in rainfall patterns, coastal erosions, melting of ice caps and glaciers, and the alteration of infectious disease ranges. The current warming is different from past warming events, because it is happening much more rapidly, and models predict that Earth will warm between 2 and 6 degrees Celsius in the next century, a rate at least 20 times faster than past warming events. The impacts of global warming are significant and affect both oceans and humans. The rising sea levels caused by warming temperatures will result in increased coastal flooding, beach erosion, and salinization of water supplies. The IPCC's report finds that limiting warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius will help reduce the impacts on both oceans and humans. Limiting warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius would also reduce increases in ocean temperature and acidity and decreases in oxygen levels, which pose significant risks to marine biodiversity, fisheries, and ecosystems. Furthermore, limiting warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius could reduce the number of people susceptible to climate-related poverty risks by as much as several hundred million by 2050. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share, and subscribe our channel for more such videos.